Welcome back, everyone. Ready to go deeper into the deep space divorce saga?
Always ready for liftoff.
Last time we got oriented. This time we're all in on My Little Rocket Ship of Love.
Catchy title, right? Like building a new life after divorce, IS launching a spaceship.
You've got the thrill of the unknown, but also leaving behind the familiar.
Exactly. And John Oakley McElhenney, our author, really captures that. Starts right off moving into a new house.
With his kids, closer to his ex-wife, which he'd actually planned for, even during the divorce.
Shows how much he's thinking of his kids' well-being, even when his own life's upside down.
Yeah, that's mature. And the house itself sounds kind of interesting. Older place, its own quirks.
Ah, yes. He mentions a dishwasher fiasco, almost like the house is going through a transition too.
Mirroring his own journey, like a parallel story. And then there's that blind dog.
Finding new life in the backyard, but causing chaos inside during that cold snap, right?
Yeah. Life goes on even after divorce. Leaky faucets, crazy pets, you know.
Exactly. But it's how he uses humor to tell it. Like finding a way to laugh at the absurdity, good coping mechanism.
Lightens the mood for sure.
Yeah.
But then things get interesting. A new romantic partner appears.
The co-pilot, as he called her. Setting up the house seems like she's there to stay. Big step.
After just going through a divorce.
Yeah.
And that co-pilot metaphor is really something.
Suggests partnership navigating this new chapter together. He's cautious, understandably.
But hopeful too, like a new beginning is possible.
Absolutely. It's not just about the new partner though, is it? Co-parenting with the ex-wife is still happening.
Oh yeah, he talks about child support and some leftover tension from the past. But he wants her to be happy.
That struck me too. He genuinely wants the best for her, even though they're not together.
That's pretty big of it. Like they're steering their own ships, but still working together to keep the kids' ship on course.
That's a great way to put it. A delicate balance, that's for sure. And it takes communication, compromise.
Putting aside personal feelings for the kids.
Right.
He gets that, which is encouraging. Not sugarcoating how hard it is.
But showing he's willing to work towards healthy co-parenting. Important message for anyone going through something similar.
Absolutely. Divorce is rough, but doesn't have to be a total disaster. New normal, happiness, stability, as possible.
And prioritizing the kids' well-being, even when it's tough. Speaking of tough, that IKEA trip story.
Oh man, the IKEA trip. Like even simple errands become an adventure when you're juggling this new life.
But it also says something about his bond with his daughter, don't you think?
You mean her picking the furniture and keeping him on his diet with the cinnamon rolls?
Yeah, she's not just along for the ride, she's shaping this new life too and looking out for her dad.
Small detail, but says a lot. Their relationship is changing, becoming even stronger.
She's almost like a co-pilot herself, helping him through this new terrain. Really touching to see.
Speaking of touching, that final scene. Him icing in with his new partner. What did you think of that?
It's a quiet moment, but powerful. Not about big declarations, just being present with each other, finding comfort.
Yeah, a sense of peace and belonging starting to grow. Hopeful end to a chapter with a lot of ups and downs.
It makes you wonder, what's next for them? Will it be smooth sailing or more turbulence ahead?
I guess we'll find out. Makes you think. We all go through changes, finding our own co-pilots, building our own ships.
Navigating the unknown takes courage and hope. And that's what I find so relatable about it. It's not just, oh, divorce. It's about bouncing back, finding your feet when things are messy.
Gives you something to think about, especially if you've been through it yourself. Ever felt like you needed a co-pilot in life? Someone to help through a tough time?
Oh, absolutely. We all need those people. Support, encouragement, sometimes even a little push when we're stuck. Doesn't have to be romantic either.
Right, like a friend, family, mentor. Anyone who keeps you steady offers a new view. Not always the lovey-dovey kind of co-pilot.
Exactly. And it's interesting how the author contrasts that co-pilot role with the ex-wife, right?
Yeah.
Like, that's a different partnership entirely. The romance is over, but they're tied by the kids, and they're both trying to make it work.
It's almost as if they're captains of their own ships, but part of a larger fleet, working together for this common goal, raising their kids well.
Love that analogy, because it shows how complex blended families are. It's nonstop negotiating, balancing what everyone needs.
Not easy, but he seems committed to making it work. And that's where that whole spaceship idea really shines, I think.
Yeah, it lets him explore all this, and away we get, you know? The spaceship becomes the family, and space travel. It's like the challenges of divorce, co-parenting, finding new love. It's all there.
So smart. And it makes you realize, these are universal experiences. We've all got ships to steer, journeys to take, and hopefully some co-pilots to help out.
We're not alone in this. Even when it's turbulent, there's always a chance to find a new course, a new destination, maybe even a new co-pilot along the way. Couldn't have said it better myself. And what's powerful about this chapter, it doesn't pretend it's easy, you know? It admits the mess, the heartbreak, the uncertainty that comes with divorce.
But it still leaves you with some hope that you can build something good, even from the wreckage.
Absolutely. It's like finding your way in the dark, trusting your gut, believing in connection, even when it shows up in unexpected ways.
And reminding us, even when our ships get banged up a bit, we can always fix them up, make them better, and set off for something better.
Powerful stuff. So what does this all mean for our listeners? How can they use this in their own lives?
Good question. It's almost like a masterclass in resilience. Shows us that even huge changes, we can create a new normal, put our kids first, Andy have a healthy co-parenting relationship. Who knows, maybe even find love again. And it's not about reaching some perfect endpoint, is it? It's the journey itself.
Exactly. The ups, the downs, it's all part of it. Finding those good moments, the connections, that's what makes it worthwhile.
Those little things like him icing in or sharing that cinnamon roll.
Right. Seemingly small, but so powerful. Shows you the human spirit, how we bounce back.
This deep dive's really got us thinking. What's coming up next for our listeners?
Well, the next chapter is called Single Parent Moon Landing into the Sea of Tranquility. So we'll see what this family's up against.
Will they make co-parenting work? Will they find love? Will their spaceship reach its destination? Gotta find out.
We do. But for our listeners right now, I think the question is, what parts of this really hit home for you?
Yeah. How do we navigate change? How do we build our own ships in life?
That's what I want folks thinking about, because it makes you look at your own journey and use what we've learned from this saga.
Our author and his crew have been through a lot, but we'll be back with them soon for Single Parent Moon Landing. Can't wait.
Until then, everyone, keep exploring, keep learning,
sure,
and keep building those rocket ships of love, whatever they look like for you.